Welcome to an introduction to the RMTrack issue tracking application. This video provides an overview of the issue list page and the issue details page. After logging in, you'll land on the issue list page, which will display a list of issues based on the selected filter. Across the top of all pages is the main menu bar. Issues or home always takes you back to this page. Create an issue, filter management, any reports or administration tools you have access to. Help gives you links to the user guide and the support site, a search box, and over on the right, logout, change password, and change personal profile. Let's take a closer look at filtering. First time you log in, you'll be using a default filter called Assigned to Me. After that, RMTrack will return to the last saved filter you were using. Each filter must contain three conditions: number of issues, status of the issues, and project. The default filter is set to first 25 open issues in any project and an extra condition assigned to myself. To change the criteria of a condition, click on the value to see a list of alternate values for that condition. New conditions can be added to the filter by clicking Add Condition, which will display a list of all fields. Clicking on a field name will allow a condition for that field to be entered. More conditions can be created for projects, user ID fields, and for some dropdowns. To create an OR condition, just add multiple conditions for the same field, and the filter will put them together. To remove a condition, click on the value, and at the bottom of each list will be a choice of All, Any, Anytime, Anybody, or Remove. Selecting one of these will remove the condition. Each filter must have a minimum of one sort column. The default is to sort by issue number. Clicking on a column header will change the primary sort to that column. Or clicking on the sort column name in the filter will allow a different field to be selected. Which columns are displayed in the list is controlled by the field chooser, which is found under the menu icon over on the right. On the left side are all the fields defined in your RMTrack installation. On the right are the fields currently displayed in the issue list. Fields can be selected and dragged and dropped from one side to the other. Multiple fields can be selected and moved using Control Click. The order of the fields can be changed and extra rows added. Columns can also be dragged into position on the list itself by clicking on the column header and dragging to the desired position. Column widths can be changed by clicking on the column dividers and dragging. All of the details about the issue list display, the filter criteria, sort fields, what fields to display, and the column widths are all stored together with the filter. When we started this session, we were using the default filter assigned to me. Note that the filter name has now changed to Assigned to Me Unsaved. Filters can be saved and managed from the filter menu item. Clicking Save will save the current filter, including all its conditions and associated settings. You can give the current filter a new name or overwrite the current filter. Depending on your security settings, you may also be allowed to publish your filters to other users. You can also delete the current filter, or choose one of your saved filters, or choose from the Publish Filters list. In the middle of the top menu bar is a search box that can be used from any page of RMTrack to search the issues in your database. You can search a specific issue number or enter a search phrase. Note that when you use the search box, it actually clears your current filter and creates a new search filter. You can also add a search condition to an existing filter by clicking on Add Condition, scrolling to the bottom of the field list, and selecting Search, and typing your word or phrase there. As for the list of issues itself, on the left in the blue column are the links to open individual issues. Issues can be selected in the list by clicking anywhere in the row to the right of the blue column, which will open the Quick Reassign function. The Quick Reassign function allows items to be moved in the workflow or reassigned without actually opening the Issue Details page. Multiple rows can be selected using Control Click or a range of rows by using Shift Click. Now let's take a look at the Issue Details page. The center of the form is where the data fields for this issue are found. Each installation of RMTrack can have different fields in different forms, so this is just an example of what to expect. There are several different types of data fields in RMTrack: dropdowns, dates, checkboxes, text fields, and comment logs. Comment logs are a bit different than regular fields. Each user can enter their comment, and when the issue is saved, the comment is added to the log with the timestamp and the user ID. At the bottom of every Issue Details page are three very important drop-downs: Resolution, Assigned To, and Status. These fields are what move the issue through the process or workflow. Let's take a quick look at a workflow. The properties of the arrows and boxes control how the issue can move and what users the issue can be assigned to. If there are multiple paths from where the issue currently is, then there will be multiple choices available in the resolution dropdown. Changing the resolution will change the values in the Assign To dropdown to be a list of possible assignees at the next step. At the top of the page beside the issue number, you will probably see some page options. There will usually be a copy link, and you may have the option to subscribe or unsubscribe from an issue. If you are subscribed to an issue, you will receive an email alert whenever the issue is updated. In the top right corner are navigation buttons that allow you to step forward and backward through the issue list or return to the issue list. Down the right side of the issue details page, you will see some things that are associated with the current issue. The first is attachments. These are documents or images you want stored with the issue, like attachments on an email. Next we have subscribers. This is a list of all the users subscribed to this issue. If your setup allows it, you may also be able to subscribe or unsubscribe other users. Under subscribers is related items. Related items are links to either other issues in RMTrack or to any URL you want to create a link to. Attachments, subscribers, and related items can be removed by checking the boxes beside the item and then saving. Last is the issue history section. Each time an issue is saved, RMTrack will create a history record logging the changes to the issue. The main changes are always visible, and full details of the update by clicking on Details. On a final note, under the Help menu is a link for Help for This page, which will launch the RMTrack user guide in a new tab and put you on the appropriate help page. All the information I provided and a whole lot more can be found in the guide. Thank you for your time, and please feel free to contact support@rmtrack.com if you have any questions.